B-17. You've heard the name before, but do you really know why it was so good? Why is it so talked about? Why was it used so much in World War II? Well, in today's video, we're gonna get straight to that. Why was the B-17 so good? The B-17 was a four-engined aircraft with two frontal landing gears and one rear landing gear. It had a pilot and a co-pilot. It had bombs on it and gunners, so it was not a fighter. It was a bomber. Long range, could get from A to B and return to A, just like that. The B-17 had a quick speed of 239 miles per hour, or 385 kilometers per hour, those of you who aren't living in America. Now, these planes were strong and had great defenses against all of its enemies that were up against them, but had their own weaknesses. B-17 began production in 1935 and stopped around May of 1945, and there was 12,732 B-17s ever produced, but 4,000 of them were lost. Now, to talk about the B-17, you first have to talk about its defensive weapons. This plane had 10 crew members. Eight of these crew members had machine guns. Now, it had two turrets, a ball turret down at the bottom. This would watch the bottom, and this would usually be filled by the smallest crew member. This was on the F model, and went up to the G model as well. And the B-17 also had a top turret, which was also accompanied by the radio gunner, just a 50 caliber machine gun from the back window of the top of the B-17. All of the guns on the B-17 were 50 caliber machine guns, and they were very powerful.
And at 3 o'clock, need bathroom, with you?
I see them. I'm on them. Come on, you.
There was two machine guns up at the front for the bombardier and our map person. I forgot what they're called. Our guide. But they both had their own machine guns, and on the G model, they added a turret down at the bottom, and I'm not sure who that was controlled by. I'm more familiar with the B-17F model. There was two waist gunners down the middle, right behind the wings of the plane, and they were both equipped with 50 caliber machine guns. And they were usually the first to get their strikes because they have the most visibility across the aircraft other than the top and bottom turrets. And to top it all off, there's a rear gunner, or a tail gunner. He's probably the most vital gunner of all because he prevented planes from coming behind and just shooting off all their tail, their ailerons, and everything like that. Now, some of their offensive weapons, this would include bombs, mostly bombs. Actually, only bombs. The B-17 never dropped torpedoes. It was a long-range, high-altitude bomber. Now, it could carry up to 8,000 pounds of ordnance, but they were only usually scheduled to carry 4,000 pounds. This would usually consist of 8 500 pound bombs or 4 1,000 pound bombs. Now, the range of the B-17, like I just said, it is just about 2,000 miles. So, I'm just about a 3,000 miles back and forth. So this made it great for striking deep in Germany on their factories and all of their like hardware, the FW90 and BF109 factories. It was never used in the Pacific. It was only used in Germany. In the Pacific, that was always naval warfare, so it was always stuff like that. The survivability of the B-17, it is, like, very, very high. The crew survivability, not so much. The B-17 wasn't armored or anything very much. Like, there was some windows that were maybe put around that were bulletproof, but not much armor on this thing. But there have been stories of B-17s. There was a BF-109 that crashed into a B-17 and cut like a huge gash in the side. I'll link a video to it about this story by Yarnhub. He makes great World War II and other war stories. But a BF-109 rips through the tail, and the B-17 still makes it home. And I've heard even from that they could survive with one engine left and they'd still make it home. The models of the B-17 include, they did not vary much differently. The G variant only added a frontal turret, which just, I believe it helped with just keeping it more consistent with shooting and other stuff like that. And it was just completely new that I don't think they had any other machine guns up there except for that turret on the G model. Bomber of World War II, and the most effective one, because I believe it single-handedly destroyed most of all the factories that produced the air superiority that Germany had, and it had just all, it had full coverage of all the space of it, had so many bombs that it could just flatten terrain, flatten everything around it. And the B-17 is just one of the greatest bombers. Even it still stands up today as one of the greatest bombers we've ever had in history. But, you know, that might just be me. You know, it can be taken up by the B-2, which is very new, the B-29, which is still that era. But, you know, B-17 is just one of the greatest bombers we've ever seen fly in the sky. Well, if you guys want me to do more videos like this, I think I'm gonna be doing more stuff like this because it still ties in with what my content is, and I'm probably gonna do like the P-51, the P-47, a bunch of World War II planes, and then I'm gonna keep progressing up into more modern stuff like F-18, a B-2, you know, like I said. But if you guys like this, please subscribe and like the video. If I can get to like 1,000 likes, we'll see if I can do not a part two, but a second video just like this one on a different plane, maybe different countries. But like we could do ratings. I would really like to. I think that'd be really fun for us. We could do live streams and stuff like that. I'm really excited for the future of this channel. But if you like this, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.